Yo, what's good, boys? KShlump back at it. Today we're doing another Youth Nats review, but this time I want to shout out the Mediocritist. So yeah, let's go back to this video right here. Yeah, so if you look at this video, I'm assuming this is a kid from CRI, but like he said, could you break down the U16, U17 races? And I was like, sure. And he's like, do the quads and the eights for both. And I was like, all right, sounds good. But they don't have any quads, so we won't be reviewing quads. We'll only be reviewing the eights, the U16 eights and 17 eights. I'm a little bit tired because I just made this whole video, and the file got corrupted, and I lost it. So I have to make this whole video again. So yeah, just bear with me. I should be same thing, just like I rehearsal. It was the last one was rehearsal. Yeah, thank you. Oh yeah. So yeah. I have like some papers. Wait, what's in the back of this? Health plan payments. Yeah. Okay. So. Yeah. We'll be doing the U16-8. We'll be doing the U17-8 for Friday semifinals. And then for the AB finals on Sunday, we'll only be doing the U16-8 because unfortunately, the U17-8 did not qualify. And we're going to see why. So, yeah, let's get started. Yeah, don't I look handsome in that photo? Got more tan, more beautiful, more jacked. Now I got another health update, maybe a workout video coming soon, you know, just regular stuff. But let's go here. Yeah, so wait, what's the time? 6:58:10. Oh yeah, bro, these videos are a pain ass to find, pain in the ass. Just spent like a good 30 minutes nonetheless just trying to find the videos in the first place. They're just like in the weirdest spots. 6:58:58. Oh, it's Saturday.
But the sprint is going to go to the benefit of Roe.
Let's mute this shit. I don't want to hear them talk. I don't know if you like anyone who's ever listened to this shit. The people talking, so annoying. They don't even know what the fuck they're talking about. Some nonsense. It's always some nonsense. Like, yeah, like, took hard time for them to be here. All that stuff, good for them. It's like, shut up. Who cares? All right, and then we're off. Oh, yeah. Last time I remember this, there's not really any good footage. I don't know if you guys watched your own replays, but, like, there's not a lot of good footage for this race. So, I hate to be the one to break it to you guys. But, yeah, we're not going to be seated. There's not going to be that much happening in the overhead. Five seats late. Oh, yeah, CRI is the third from the right. Yeah, five seats late. You can see that because there's a huge white splash in the water. Oh, wait, never mind. That's not five seat. That is three seat. Nonetheless, five seats played late. This is U16-8, so they qualify. The last one was a live reaction, but this one isn't because I've already seen the video, but you know what I'm saying. Yeah, CRI's race plan consistently seems to be like, just get off, just hit a constant pace, don't go anything past that. Like, it's not like a big, sick, all-out sprint in the beginning to get ahead, then like, main pacing. It's just more like, just get to pace as quickly as can, just keep pace. And then maybe we'll have some move in the third 500 or like the last 500, but like, CRI doesn't really do moves like that. Oh yeah, like I was saying earlier, I already said this last time. Yeah, I'm gonna go over some points again, but if you look at all other boat paths, you can see how like most of their coxswains are going in a straight line, and our coxswain, yes, not all of them are perfectly straight, whatever, but our coxswain, you can see, is very wonky with her lines. So I'm not a coxswain. I don't know how to really coach coxswains at all, really. So can't really like give advice on that. I mean, maybe because we're on the Charles, all we do is, like, their hands are always on the rudder, so they're always moving around, but I doubt that's, like, a big thing that actually matters. I would assume someone knows how to go in a straight line. This is not me shitting on anyone, just, like, maybe it's harder than I think it is. But, yeah, like, that can definitely, like, give just, like, it could give some milliseconds off, but we have to remember milliseconds add up to seconds, and, like 1 second is a quarter, is a quarter of a split, so, like, that is, you know, not that great. Well, yeah, no, I'm sorry. 1 second is, like, one split, and that's a quarter of, like, a 2K. This is 1/4 of a 2K. Wow, my math sucks. So, again, it adds up. One split off adds up to 4 seconds total. I want to get some close-up shots. Oh, yeah, I don't think there's any close-up shots until the end of the race, so... If you don't mind, we're just going to skip. I already know the outcome. You guys already know the outcome. But you guys want my advice on the actual rowing itself. You guys clear the water pretty well. So there is some good speed in that boat. The hull's not dead. You guys are clearing the strokes. Like, wow. Okay. Let's get to the line. Yeah. Is that rye? Not too bad. They're not perfect, but they're working together, and if you're working together, then you have a good boat. It doesn't really matter if you're rowing the wrong way. So, like, they can row bad all they want, but they're doing it together. That's a good crew. That's perfect. That's perfectly in sync. And that's Chicago. Oh, that's not really good. Yes, you're right. Boom, here we go. Yeah, off the bat, there's big set issues. As you can see, like, starboard side is just, like, dragging on the water. Maybe, like, bow seat has to, like, rip his oar up in the air to get to, like, to catch it. And then, yeah, this is the only footage we're going to have, so I'm just going to use this footage. But, yeah, you can just look here. It's, like, all starboard side is just having their blades, like, dragging us to water. And port side has it sky high. You can just drive a bus under it, but... I don't, yeah, like, there's so many things that when it comes to boat set, I mean, like, people could be trying to go to the catch instead of letting the catch come to them. There's, like, it could be, like, a handle height issue. It could be, about, like, the pressure in a foot versus another. It could be just, like, distrust of other teammates, because, like, just not trusting your teammates actually upsets the side of a boat. It's, like, if you think about it, imagine, like, a horse. A horse knows what you feel, so if you feel anxious or you feel distrustworthy, like, the horse or the boat will feel that, and it will emanate, like, well, it emanates. So, again, don't know what, like, you would have to be in the boat to understand what's happening, like, why the set's wrong. Like, only anything a coach can do is, like, provide suggestions. Like, good coaches can obviously see it, but I'm not, like, a crazy cracked coach. Like, I don't really know. But, yeah, let's not talk about this. Let's talk about the blade work. So, some water's being missed. That's due to, a little bit of that's due to the set, obviously. But we can see here, let's go frame by frame. We can see that people's bodies are not in the same positioning. So everyone's not completely bodies over when everyone's completely bodies over. And this can also contribute to the set. Not what I'm about to say, not just that. A big issue I'm seeing is that, like, everyone finishes the stroke and then someone decides, like, someone's like, okay, I'm gonna go bodies over and then I'm gonna put my arms out. And another guy's like, I'm gonna put my arms out and put my bodies over, which is the right thing to do. And some other guy's gonna be like, as I'm going forward, I'm gonna put my arms out at the same time, so it looks like this. And then, like, by the time I'm at my knees and they're bent, and, like, my arms are already crooked. So everyone's hands and bodies are not where they're supposed to be. It's like everyone has their own idea of where they think is the right spot to be in. But again, we have to be thinking together as a unit, one cohesive unit. If you're not a cohesive unit, you're not going to win a race. You can be bad at rowing, but if you're bad at rowing perfectly together, then, like, you're going to win. So you just need watts. But yeah, let's just keep going. Yeah, over compression, they should be catched by now. Like, right here, they should be catched. Like, look. I have to count. Wait. Four seat is like overcompressed as shit. Five seats. I don't know if five seats doing any better, really. But everyone's like, it's like, wait. I want to see this in real time. Yeah. Well, yeah. Well, let's take a second. Just look. 5 seat is strung out like a whatever gets strung out. I guess. What animals get strung out? I don't know. But like, yeah. Again, think about it like this: your body's a connective chain. Your hands, all they really do is connect. Imagine your hands is like a link that connects the oar handle to your shoulders. Okay. And think about all the pressure you're creating through the base of your feet when you catch and hit and start the drive, and when you hit the finish. What happens? Push through your legs, and to push through your legs, you need to be connected to your handles. Like, where does the force translate to? The force has to translate through your body, through your torso, into your legs to feel the connection. But what happens is that if your abdominals and your spinal extensors or erectors, either your spinal your spinal erectors. If your spinal erectors are not like strong, and if your core is not strong, and they're not like firm, and your arms aren't out, because like anything past this, like you're reaching, you're overreaching. It's like if someone's like this, that's overreaching. Because for someone to be this far, you have to expend all this energy to go out here. But then at the end of the day, when they catch, once they come back to here, are they connected? So like this amount of space that they've created is just like a waste of energy. And that's due to strong core, strong spinal extensors or erectors, and having your arms tucked, lats strong, just having a good strong body. As you can see, 5 here seat does not have that. 5 seat's like a little like boom. He's just like doing something over there. I don't know what he's doing. He's like, his force, none of the force he's translating into the oar is actually doing anything of like substance, really. And then, I don't know. This guy's looking, four seats looking out of the boat, doing his own shit. I don't know. And yeah, that's all I really have to say. Let's go back again. And yeah, wait, yeah. Four seats overcompressing. If you look at four seat, which is the fourth from the right, you can see that he bounces off the catch. That is just boat check. That is straight boat check. He doesn't even catch. It's like, just take a look. Look at the bounce. 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 Let's look again. Bounce. 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 He's overcompressing on the catch, just like dead. Dead boat speed. Again, they came third. They qualified to A finals. Good for them. Great for them. But everyone here's at nationals, so like, do I care? No, not really. It's like, I wouldn't be reviewing you guys if you didn't go to nationals. You wouldn't be being reviewed in the first place. So just like, it's a given. So all other crews come by. Yeah, I mean, it seems like they got Watts. I give it to them. Because, like, I mean, first of all, I personally am a big fan of the way CRI teaches the stroke. I think it's an efficient way of stroke. I think it's an efficient way of rowing. I think it's one of the, not the best ways to row, but I think it's, like, up there. I think that way of rowing doesn't even require that much energy. That much Watts. So, like, even if you're not that high of an erg monkey, if you row this way, you can typically be a good rower nonetheless. So that being said, they have a good stroke. They executed the stroke well. They came third, good for them, but they didn't win, so I don't care. All right, let's go with U17-8. What is this, 9:14? Ah, CRI. Let's see here. Boom. This work already? Where are they? I think they're like 2 seconds from the left. Or the right. Whatever color. They're third from the right. Third from the left. My bad. Is that Rye again? No, it's not. Yeah, boom. Wait, let's see this. Yeah, look. I mean, if you notice, Bausch's doing this thing where he's like dipping his shoulder down, then putting it back up. I mean, there's not really an issue with that per se. I mean, I feel like if he was like just dipping it down to, and then he cut, and then he like, if his body's just like designed that way, where he has to like push his shoulder down to catch, then like that's not really an issue. But like the fact that he's pushing his shoulder down and pushing it back up means that he's fatigued, one, or two, he's just like, it's just a force of habit. It's just like he wants like his blade to be clear to push it down. But then the thing is, if it's all the way down, he has to put it back up, raise his hands again to catch it. And then if that happens, then think about it. You're holding the handle, push it down, get air time to make sure your blade clears the water, which is like means that you don't have faith in the boat, or just again, bad just repetition of motions, which is forced habits. Or he pushed, and then you push your hand back up and you catch. And what happens is that your handle, which is in your hand, is doing like all this like vertical movement, and that's just like contributing to poor set. Because the thing is, like literally, rowing's all horizontal. You just want to get from here to here, just horizontal. Everything is traveling horizontally. Your blade, your handle, your body, it's all traveling on this conveyor belt that has like the most minimal amount of vertical motion ever. And like the thing that really hurts things the most is like having all that vertical motion. The last thing you want is vertical motion, because it just, well, yeah, it's just, you don't need it. You're not going up, you're going sideways, you're going horizontally. So like any energy or things you do to make everything go vertical, you're just killing boats, not killing boats, but you're not really, you're wasting energy. It's all waste energy. And rowing's just like this like the conservation of energy, in my opinion. Let's go again. Yeah, if you guys see, like, there's a slight pause at the catch, especially with, like, bow and some of them. Like, bro, these guys look like they're really struggling to push. It's like, the boat looks dead. The boat looks really dead, actually. Like, it gets in the water, but look at this. There's no, look at their legs. There's nothing moving. The leg drive's not quick. And especially when they come in, there's, like, that micro pause, and they don't come out. And, like, I don't know. I just don't think they're working together, number one. Number two, I don't think they have a good rhythm. And they don't have a good rhythm because they're not working together. And I don't know what the experience of these guys are, personally. It's like, this is just me, like, with my eyes looking at, like, the screen, because I've never met these kids. I don't know how long they've been rowing for, but they're not working as a cohesive unit, one. That's all I can say. And they look tired. They look really tired. Like, what almost all of them should be doing is, like, trying to row, like, rowing, like, four-seat. Four-seat, like, has a very solid rhythm. But their leg drive's too slow. Like their stern, their stern is just crashing into the front. Like, their stroke seat is just, like, going to the front, leaning over, just, like, trying to push. Yeah, and, like, there's some missing water. I mean, like, that's just an off-stroke right there. But, like, their handle, their blades are not the same height. Bow seat's, like, not doing his... Bow seat's in his own world. Feathers are off. I mean, to be honest with you, just, like, it seems like a crew that just hasn't practiced. That's all it really looks like. It's, like, there's, like, so many things I can point out. Like, I can, like, it's, like... These are what, U17s? Yeah. Like, these guys are going to varsity next year. Like, probably going to varsity next year. Maybe they're just, like, going to do another year at U17. Nonetheless, they're probably sophomores. Maybe they're juniors. Who knows? But what's happening is that they're, like, there's so many things, like, there's so many things I can point out. Like, they're feathering with their outside hand. They're pushing the oar away like this, while they're leaning over. They're not bringing in the handle and tucking it down with their with their inside wrist and pushing it out with their outside hand. There's like they're pulling in, pushing down, pushing out, and just ripping their hands forward. There's like just this crew has not practiced enough. They need more rowing time together as a boat. One and two, they need more technical work, because it's like this is not like this. Because a lot of their issues aren't minute issues that like cost them like some things. It's like. Their technical problems made them not qualify for finals on Sunday. So that's it really. They need to lock in more. There needs to be more work time to be done. Cause I feel like if these guys had another month, if these guys really cared and like were like really serious about this, I'm not saying they're not. I don't know them, but like, if they're really serious about this. If they had another month and they like really focused and dialed down and really got like the nitty gritty work done, I think these guys could have been a finals crew. But like again, I just don't think they had enough time. So to get it to work. So yeah, I'll see the race. Yeah, they started pretty behind ish, and their lead never caught up. The boat speed looked very like the boat didn't look like it was moving. Like I feel like. The crew is very tired, either from like from time trials or I don't know, whatever. But I can relate. Like this course sucks. It's really hot, and I just like want to die every single time I'm there. But let's see what's. They probably finished like third to last. Is that Rye? Rye's rowing. I like that. That's some decent rowing. But yeah, third to last, barely, maybe fourth to last. I don't know. All right, let's go to AB finals on Sunday. What is that? 3:24. Bro, these ads, bro. They're making them, bro. You're getting wild with these double ads, I'm not gonna lie. Like, I don't know what they're doing, what they think they can do. 324.04. Let's see. So, yeah, as you can tell, Sierra is the big red boat from the second on the right. Same thing, same race plan as it seems. It seems like they just started out, you know, just like get the pace, keep pace, don't move, do anything else. I'm like, so far at CR, we've never been taught like sprints, like end race sprints. Like Greenwich's sprints are terrifying. These guys will just eat through a crew on the last 250 meters. Like, oh my goodness, their sprints are so scary. They're a good team. They recently become a good team. They used to be trash. I want some close up shots. They're still delayed to catch. Like, I mean, you can look at this. I don't know who this is. That's Ryan, obviously. What is this? I don't even know what team that is in front of me. TBC Racing, whatever. But like, as you can see, it's like there's no hesitation. It's like them, like they get to the catch, like their blades are in the water. They press, they move. It's still a bit late, but like, it's very together. It's very terrific. That's like, hands are out after like the hands are out immediately. Like there's like no pause. It's all just recovery. Like, just chain, just like supply chain, boom, 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 boom. That's Rye, sorry. That's Rye over there. That's not. I don't know. Those guys look very similar to Rye. Where's your Rye? Oh. Damn. I'm going to get some close-up shots on you guys. They just do not care about U16 racing, huh? These camera angles are dog. Oh, I'm tired. It's been a long day. Yeah, you can see their form give up a little bit because like their catches are slowing down. It's like they're increasing the rate, but the catches slow down, which means that the drive slows down. It's like, oh, that guy is getting his legs down fast before everyone else. Yeah, okay, let's see. Where's your eye? Where's your bro? Where is it? Okay. Yeah, you can see everyone's handles are like kind of going like they catch and the handles just go like, ooh, it's like there's no like solid. It seems like they're only pressing with their legs. It seems like they're taking that. It feels like their hands are just connected to their legs, right? It doesn't seem like their hands are connected to their shoulders, which are connected to their torso, which is connected to their hips, which is connected to their legs, which is connected to their feet. It feels like their hands are directly related to their legs because it feels like their It genuinely feels like, from what it looks like, it doesn't seem like their torsos are doing much work. It seems like they just have the connection. The moment the leg drive's done, they just whip the arms in. And it's like... because this is the way I see it. And yeah, sorry, there wasn't much video for like the final, so like I'm doing my best. But like, this is what I see it, right? Your legs are like a huge engine. And this engine is like creating torque. And that's what your legs are for. On the leg drive, especially on the beginning of the leg drive, when you're prying and you're like that little like first half, maybe the first quarter, you're creating all this potential energy that you're like, and you take this potential energy and you load the blade, and that's why you have the ore bend and on the skinnies, on the smoothie twos, and you create this bend in the ore in the shaft as you're driving. And what happens is that as your legs are going all the way down, because remember, as your legs go all the way down, like the strokes complete all together, like legs go down, body over, just like hands in, like as your legs go down completely. So as like you're finishing like the end of the leg drive and your bodies are coming over, you use all that potential energy you created and you like use the arms and you bring it in and you snap the oars out. You snap the oar out of the water. And that's like the final bit that like sends the boat back. It's like a load. It's like, man, yeah. Oh shit, I almost fell over my chin. I'm getting my chin. Okay. It's like you load, and then right here, send, snap. Then you come again, it's like load, send, snap. Oh, so, that being said, they have to take their blades, load it full of potential energy, and then release it. But I don't think they're doing that. It seems like they think it's just like the leg drive, big ergs, big leg, just like push down, go that way. I don't think so. Yeah. So yeah, I think that's it really. This is a shorter video. Yeah. Oh, Marin. Is that what the fuck they're called? I don't even know who these people are. Oh, Marin. Oh, I'm so retarded. Sorry, I'm Marin. I was like, what? Okay, that's it. Yeah, so yeah, I didn't have that much to talk over this time because, you know, seems like the camera guys just hate the U17s and U16s. But, yeah, again, I was like a novice coach for 6 months, and I'm not a craft rower, I'm not like a craft coach, right? So like you can take my comments with a grain of salt. I don't really care. I'm just providing my advice. So yeah, this is my 2 cents on the people's racing here. I want to thank the mediocritist for suggesting this. Thank you. I hope I get more user interactions, like more viewer interactions soon, like more suggestions on what I should do. I thought that was really cool. So yeah, thank you, mediocritist. Shout out to you. And other than that, I want to thank everyone for watching. And I'll see you guys in the next one. I'm glad in love, ooh, ooh. But you can't blame me for trying. You know I'd be lying, saying you're the one. Ooh, ooh. That could finally fix me. Looking at my history, I'm bad.
she could really